The House essentially stopped their investigation long ago, while the Senate investigation under a Republican majority has continued in Intel. I'm not surprised that the House has restarted the investigation that frankly should have been ongoing when there was a Republican majority House.
You know, this is their plan all along. It's basically going to preclude our ability to pass any kind of bipartisan legislation because they're just sucking up all the oxygen. The Mueller investigation needs to be completed. We've got investigations in both houses and the Intelligence Committee. We're still working on the Intelligence Committee investigation in the Senate. And so far, there's been really not much to show for it, no evidence of collusion. And our Democratic colleagues can't stand it. This is all about setting up the stage for impeachment proceedings. That's pretty clear.
Donald Trump Jr. and Michael Cohen belong back in front of the Senate Judiciary Committee. We need to continue our investigation, which was unfortunately short-circuited and stopped.
Do you think that Michael Cohen is a credible witness?
Michael Cohen is highly credible. In fact, more credible by the day as additional documents are discovered, and he may be a convicted felon for having lied to Congress, but he has everything to lose by continuing to lie now and nothing to gain. That's why I think everything he knows ought to be before our Senate Judiciary Committee.
There are too many people in Washington, D.C., on both sides of the aisle that they think they're smarter and more virtuous than the American people. And they condescend to the American people while drinking their goat's milk lattes. And they sell the American people short. I guess where I'm leading with this is, I think most Americans, whether they agree or disagree with what, for example, the House Judiciary Committee is doing, recognize it for what it is. It's politics. I mean, it's not fact-finding. It's politics.